country's red, don't you know? And that's pretty much what I was expressing in my poem. The American government, they're sneaky. They're very deceitful. They're the liars. They're cheats. They're ripoffs. I mean, the American government is one systematic government that nobody can trust. I don't trust them myself.
How long have you been writing?
Huh?
How long have you been writing?
Since I was four.
Yeah, this sort of thing a lot of, like, open mic benefits.
Oh, I love open mic. I love coming here to an open mic, absolutely.
What kind of reactions do you usually get?
Usually people are pretty much in agreement with what I'm saying.
We overheard you before talk about you went to court today for a speeding ticket.
That's accurate.
Wait, do you want to tell us that story?
Yes, absolutely. I wouldn't mind telling you the story. I went to court today for a speeding ticket, and I told the judge, let me tell you something. And you listen good. I'm only gonna say this one time and one time only. I don't repeat myself for nobody, I said. I says, I'm here to pay a speeding ticket, not to listen to your lectures and hear you run your mouth for an hour. I says, I'm here to pay off my speeding ticket, and I'm here to get my fines out of the way and get the fuck to work. The judge says, you can't talk like that in my courtroom. You're in contempt of court. Then I said, Judge, if that's the best you can do, I feel sorry for you. I said, why don't you just shut your fucking mouth for once and listen? I said, I'm not gonna take your shit. I said, I'm gonna pay my speeding ticket, like I said. I walked up to the goddamn bench and I handed my $25 up and I says, there's my money. Now I am leaving. And I left it at that. To get loud. I says, you can't do a goddamn thing about it because I'm expressing myself in your court and there is nothing you can do about it. You think you're God because you have a rope and you can put people up the goddamn river for 20 years? Well, you're not. And I don't get it back. Cheats, they rip the people off. That's the American government for you. America is a third world country and people don't recognize it. And I think that's pretty goddamn sad that they don't recognize their own country as a third world, third rate, third class slum.
assault rifle. I own a 12-gauge double-barrel shotgun. I own a regular shotgun. I own a regular hunting rifle. I own a 9mm, a 357, a 45 handgun, a 38 special. And I own an M16 fully automatic round assault rifle.
Yeah, she was going to lead that to the reserve.
Think things are going to get better before they get worse?
No way. Things are just going to get worse and keep on getting worse. Like I said, America's a third world country as it is, and you know, we're just basically in a hopeless situation as it stands.
What do you think this country's going to look like in the year 2003?
You know, I'll tell you the truth, nothing against you guys, but I don't want to answer that question because I haven't even got a mind that inhumane.
You ready for what's coming?
Ready as I'll ever be.
Most people are.
It's a little saying. Dates back for generations. So be prepared for anything at any time from anybody, and don't take no shit. Always stand your ground. People want to come up to me and run their mouth. Guess what? I'll throw them through the fucking window. I won't think a thing of it.
Would you mind reciting your poem for us?
Not at all. I don't see why I couldn't. There's an evil virus that's threatening mankind. It's not a state of the art, it's a serious state of the mind. The bug is the backstab, is the two-faced lead, a menace to society, a social disease. To brainwash the mind is a social disorder. The cynics, the apathy, went up in chip order. Watching beginnings of social decay, gloating and staring at life's disarray. Eating away at your own self-esteem, pouncing on every word that you might be saying. To attack someone's mind is a social disorder. The Constitution, the government, martial law, order. Superficially smiling, a shake of the hand as soon as your back is turned, treason is planned. When every good thing's laid to rest by the government's hate, by the Constitution and their lies. And every time you think you're safe, and when you go to turn away, you know they're sharpening all their knives. All in your mind, all in your head, try to relate it. All in your mind, all in your head, try to escape it. Without a conscience, they destroy, and that's the thing that they enjoy. There are sickness that's in all of our minds. They want to sink the ship and leave the way they laugh at you and me. You know it happens all the time, but it only happens in your mind. The rats in the cellar, you know who you are, or do you? Watching beginnings of social decay.